What is designing of curve? It is nothing but finding a convenient radius to implement the curve on the roads.
At any circumstances, we must know the most accurate deflection angle at the point of intersection. Most of the design of curves done by with the help of the apex distance.
Now, let us calculate the radius using the tangent length.
Distance equals to 300 into 0.1056. That gives the value.
Final design values are. The radius of the curve is 300 meters.
Now, let us see the setting out of a simple curve.
The half of the deflection angle, which is theta by 2, is equivalent to the angle between the tangent line to the chord length.
Hence, our design and the setting out is correct.
Similarly, we can calculate for any curve length required until we reach to the tangent point 2.
Welcome to Civil Guru. These videos made in different languages, like English, Hindi, Tamil, and also in Arabic now. Please choose your desired language from our playlist. If you like this video, please like and subscribe now, and share it with your friends. Thank you. In this episode, we will see about the design of a simple curve. Before going in deep about the design, we must remember the elements of curves and their important formulas. We have already discussed in our previous episode about the derivation of formulas by using the simple trigonometry method. Hope most of the people watched that episode. If anyone is missed that, we have given here the link of that episode in the description. Please watch that, it will help more to understand about the design of curves. What is designing of curve? It is nothing but finding a convenient radius to implement the curve on the roads. The design of curve is done in the following circumstances. 1. While developing an existing road. Or 2. While constructing a new road. In both the cases, we need some information from the site. We have to observe the field data as much as possible. At least, we need minimum of 2 measurements from the site to design accurately. At any circumstances, we must know the most accurate deflection angle at the point of intersection. Without the deflection angle, we cannot design the curve. In addition to that, if the existing road is available, we can measure the approximate length of the tangent length. And it is important to know the approximate distance of the apex. The apex distance controls the alignment of the proposed road. If the existing road is available, the lowermost distance from the point of intersection to the existing road is the apex distance. And if it is construction of new road, the center of the land available for the construction at the mid-ordinate of the curve shall be considered as the center of the proposed road. And the distance from the intersection point to this center of the proposed road shall be considered as apex distance. Most of the design of curves done by with the help of the apex distance. That's why it is considered as very important element to know in highway engineering. These are all the basic requirements from the field for the design of a simple curve. Now, let us see a sample of the design of a simple curve. The following measurements are taken from the site. 1. The chainage of the intersection point is 1 plus 192. That is 1,192 meters. 2. The deflection angle is 50 degree, 30 minutes. 3. The approximate tangent length measured at site is 141.50 meters. And 4. The approximate apex distance measure at site is 31.70 meters. Now, let us calculate the radius using the tangent length. The formula for the tangent length equals to radius into tan theta by 2. Now, the radius equals to the tangent length divided by tan theta by 2. Accordingly, the radius equals to 141.50 divided by tan 25 degree 15 minutes. That gives the value of 300.023 meters. let us assume the radius as 300 meters for easy calculation purpose while setting out the curve. And recalculate the accurate tangent length. Again, the tangent length equals to radius into tan theta by 2. That is 300 into tan 25 degree 15 minutes. This gives the value of 141.48 meters. That means the final tangent length is 141.48 meters. Now, let us find the radius using apex distance and cross-check the value of radius derived using the tangential method. As we have seen in our previous episode, the apex distance equal to the hypotenuse minus the radius. That is, the radius divided by cos theta by 2 minus the radius. That is, radius into 1 divided by cos theta by 2 minus 1. The apex distance 31.70 meters equals to radius r into 1 divided by cos 25 degree 15 minutes minus 1. Here, the value of 1 divided by cos 25 degree 15 minutes equals to 1.1056. That is, 31.70 meters equals to r into 1.1056 minus 1. That is, 31.70 equals to r into 0.1056. Now, the radius r equals to 31.70 divided by 0.1056. This gives the value of 300.189 meters. Let us say 300 meters for easy calculations. Now, the final apex distance equals to 300 into 0.1056. That gives the value of 31.68 meters. For setting out, we need the curve length. For that, let us finalize the radius as 300 meters and calculate the curve length. As we know from the previous episode, the length of the curve is pi r into theta divided by 180. That is, pi into radius 300 into 50 degrees 30 minutes divided by 180. This gives the value of 264.42 meters. The final curve length is 264.42 meters. As a result, the final design values are: the radius of the curve is 300 meters. The tangent length is 141.48 meters. The curve length is 264.42 meters. The apex distance is 31.68 meters. Now, let us fix these values on site. The chainage of the intersection point is 1192 meters. The chainage of the tangent point 1, or the point of the curve, is 1192 meters minus the tangent length of 141.48 meters. This gives the value of 1050.52 meters. And the chainage of tangent point 2, or the point of tangent, is 1052.52 meters plus the curve length 264.42 meters. That gives the value of 1314.94 meters. This is called the design of simple curve. Now, let us see the setting out of a simple curve. There are many methods of setting out of the curve is in practice. However, the instrumental method, which is known as the theodolite method, is the most accurate method. In the instrumental method, the deflection angle method is the most convenient and popular method used in road projects. This method is also known as the Rankine's method. In this method, we just need only the radius and the maximum curve length for setting out purpose. In this method, the setting out done by fixing of pegs with small and regular intervals. And the distance is measured from one peg to another peg. So it is assumed that the chord length measured from one peg to another peg is approximately equivalent to the arc length of that segment. As we have seen in our previous episode, the deflection angle theta at the intersection point is equivalent to the included angle in between the two tangent points. Here, we must know one more thing. The half of the deflection angle, which is theta by 2, is equivalent to the angle between the tangent line to the chord length. If we name this angle as delta, then the theta equals to 2 delta. Let us remember this, and we will go further in the derivation of the formula. As we have seen in our previous episode, the curve length C is pi into r into theta divided by 180. That is, C divided by pi into r equals theta divided by 180. Which is 180 C divided by pi into r equals theta. That is equals 2 delta. Now, we need the value of a delta to fix the curve from a tangent point. So, the value of delta equals 90 C divided by pi r. That gives the value of 28.648 into C divided by r. This value is in degrees. Sometimes, the value of delta arrives in less than a degree. So, let us derive a formula to calculate in minutes. In that case, the value of delta equals 90 into 60 C divided by pi r. That gives the value of 1718.873 into C divided by r. Finally, let us say 1718.9 C divided by r. Which is, in minutes. Let us make a sample of calculation. For that, we will take the same data of the curve design previously. Let us assume the first arc length is 20 meters. That is, the distance of the first peg from the tangent point is 20 meters. And the radius of curve is 300 meters. Now, the value of delta equals 28.648 into 20 divided by 300. This gives the value of 1 degree, 54 minutes, and 36 seconds. Let us cross-check with another formula, which is 1718.9 into 20 divided by 300. That gives the value of 114.593 minutes, which is 114.593 divided by 60 equals 1 degree, 54 minutes, and 36 seconds. We have confirmed here that both the formulas gives the same values. Now, let us cross-check the value of a delta from the known curve length of 264.42 meters with the same radius of 300 meters, which is 28.648 into 264.42 divided by 300. This gives the value of 25 degree 15 minutes. By using another formula, which is 1718.9 into 264.42 divided by 300. That gives the value of 15:15. If we divide this with 60 minutes, then we get the value of 25 degree 15 minutes, which is equivalent to theta by 2 of our curve designed. Hence, our design and the setting out is correct. Similarly, we can calculate for any curve length required until we reach to the tangent point 2. For setting out the curve on site, if required, we can create a table based on the distance from tangent point to any particular chainage. In the next episode, we will see the method of designing and setting out of transition curves and super elevation. If you like these videos, please subscribe now and share with your friends. And also don't forget to press the bell button. Thank you.